Hi there! My name is Aida, Qistina from 3 in 10, and now that you've been truly greeted, let's get down to business for me to talk about my review on Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. So, grab a cup of tea, sit back, and relax as I take you to an enchanting world of magic. This book was published by Bloomsbury on the 8th of July 2000. The genre given is fantasy and it is a fiction. Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire was well written by the infamous J.K. Rowling. The main characters in this book are Harry Potter, Hermione Granger, Ron Weasley, Cedric Diggory and many more. This story was set in Hogwarts and this book contains 636 pages. In the fourth book, Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, it sees Harry Potter returning for his fourth year at Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry, along with his two friends, Hermione Granger and Ron Weasley. There is an upcoming tournament between the three major schools of magic, with one participant from each school and is selected by the Goblet of Fire. Each school being Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry, the Beauxbatons School of Magic, and the Durstrang. With Harry's name being drawn, even though he is not eligible and is a fourth player, he must compete in this dangerous event. While competing alongside Cedric Diggory, Fleur Bellicker, and Victor Crumb in this dangerous wizard event that has three stages and consists of dragons, a magical league that has mere people and Grindelwalds and a very huge maze, Lord Voldemort makes his return by the help of one of his fellow loyal followers, Peter Pettigrew. Harry Potter and Voldemort meets at last when Harry Potter grabs the Triwizard Cup that turns out to be a portkey and takes him to a graveyard where he has a duel with Voldemort. Somehow, Harry got away with his amazing abilities and by the help of his loved ones.
For my comments about this book, I think it was quite easy for me to understand because I have been a fan of Harry Potter for a very long time. But for beginners, I suggest you to read the books and watch the movies in sequence for you to understand the storyline and the plot way better. I find this book very, very interesting because it shows a whole new perspective of the wizardry world and it introduces so many more creatures and other wizarding students that we meet in the novel. This book is also where Lord Voldemort returns, and from an adventurous, childlike storyline, it gets very dark towards the ending of the story. While reading through this book, I felt many emotions. I was happy, I was excited, I was nervous, but by the ending, I was very much upset because one of my favorite characters died. Although there are a few things I disagree in this book, one of them being Ron Weasley was very mean and somewhat misogynistic towards Hermione, in some parts when he looked down on her and expected for no one to take her to the Yule Ball. Secondly, one of the newly introduced characters, Cho Chang, in my opinion, she could have been written much more than just being a love interest and a girl who Cedric and Harry fights over. One of the values that I learned in this story is the importance of tolerance and pushing for equality. Voldemort represents the worst in the world of bigotry, rejecting half-bloods, muggle-borns and muggles because they are not pure wizard blood. Voldemort's contempt and disregard for muggles is clearly established in the opening chapter with the murder of Frank. It's an extremely powerful image with the murder of an innocent old man, and he could have just wiped his memories away with one easy spell.
In conclusion, this book is worth the read. I recommend it to everyone as there is no right age to indulge in an incredibly magical world. Personally, I give this book a rating of 9 out of 10, as it holds so much meaning to my childhood and I love the story so much. Thank you for watching my book review. Goodbye.